Hey, this is Subramaniam Jayaram Subbu. I'm Oracle EBS Cloud SEM Manufacturing Functional Consultant. Today we are going to talk about Transform Work Order Process. As we discussed yesterday, rework and repair, and the continuation session is the Transform Work Order Process. So the Transform Work Order Process, nothing but to upgrading the products from lower version to higher version. Or sometimes you can degrade from higher version to lower version, but normally we'll go for a lower version to upper version upgradation. The best example is if you want to upgrade some engine to ultra engine, for example, V1.6 to V1.7 engines, yes, you can go for this transformation process. Or if you want to upgrade some laptops, I mean, it's an anomaly in the high-tech industries, they'll use it. And if you're going for tab or iPhone upgradations, they'll use this transform work order process. The transform work order process, there are some scenarios that, for example, I am keeping the stock 500 quantity or 1000 quantity in my warehouse. And for the next level of the product, there's only a small change, not the major change. Only I'm adding a couple of part numbers and changing it. For example, if you talk about the car companies, right? Honda 2019 model and 2020 model, just change couple of speakers and they change some front side bumpers. So in that case, it not necessarily you need to go for, you need to destroy all the scrap, all these 2019 model if it's not sale in the market. Yes, you can upgrade it and sell to the customers. Or another way that most of the people, what they would do means sometimes they may not upgrade. I mean, that they will not transform it. And they will put some promotional discounts and they will sell to the customer as much as possible to clear the stock. But Oracle is providing the functionality that you can go for a transformation process. And cloud is very simple and easy, and easy, you can easily track the process, how it works to compile in the EB systems. So we'll directly go into the system, we're going to see how the transformation process will work. If you already know, if you see my yesterday video, how the rework and repair process work, 99% same as the transform work order process. Here I have taken a couple of parts like a diesel engine and ultra diesel engine. So I have some 500 stock in my warehouse. I want to convert this diesel engine to ultra diesel engine. So I will have these two parts. One, for this part, I will remove from this engine, the existing one, and add this part number in this my one. Then I'll reproduce this new stock. So let me go into the system. So log into this cloud environment. As we told, I'm going to use most of the things as a recent database, like inventory arcs and arc structure. I mean, mainly the arc structures. And go to this, first I'll show you this part number, how it looks like. Go to the product management. Product information management, and I'm using Azure 02 as my inventory org. And go to manage items and I give this part number S21 search. So I have these two part numbers. Diesel is the, this is FG part number, this is another FG part number. I am converting, upgrading this engine to the ultra engine. Okay, this is how I created a part. The same, just apply this FG template and it will create a part. Go into this inventory management. Go to supply chain, go to inventory management. I think this is all the prerequisite. If you want to learn the manufacturing process, make sure that you learn some fundamental steps on the inventory side and procurement and the pay model, everything. Okay. Go here, manage items, quantities, and make sure that this is 02 inventory, 002 inventory, yes, 2022, 21. So I'll go for ultra first. This is the upgrade item, search. There's no stock, no results found. It means no stock exists. I'll go for some, the lower version part, just like a diesel engine. Just select this part number and click search button. And you can see there is a total 500 quantity is my total quantity, and it will be in the different inventory hours, like 00 to 500, complete is 706, and the stores is 494. So once I complete this upgrade from diesel to ultra diesel engine, then this will go for 499. One quantity will be reduced in the warehouse, and one quantity will be upgraded in my ultra deluxe engines. We are going to see after performing this, completing the manufacturing process. So let me create another window, duplicate tab. Go to homes and then supply chain execution. I'll go for supply chain execution, work execution. So on fly, I'm going to create a work definition, is everything. So I'm not creating, I don't have any predefined work structures, everything. Work definitions. So go for manage work orders. And here in the down, there's a plus. Next to that, you can see the transform work orders. Yesterday we saw the rework and repair work orders. The standard work orders, we already know this is discrete manufacturing. And the non-standard is same as a rework, transform the one, the another type, and go for a transform work order process. Once you click the transform work order process, click the show more icon. You can see, you can give your work order number, otherwise the system will provide the unique running sequence number as per the plant parameters. I'll give S21002 is my org transform work order 005 something. Okay, make sure that this is my work order number. Put it on somewhere. Put it here. I'll give the description same. And this is the item which I am going to, this upgrade item. This is the transform from item. This is the two item. This is the lower grade item, this higher end item. So S21 diesel engine ultra. This is my upgrade item. And this is my the lower grade items. Click OK. And how many quantities are you going to? I'm going for one quantity. Make sure that I don't have any work definitions. As I told you, I didn't create any work definition for this ultra deluxe instance. On fly, I'm going to create it now. Save and edit. And I don't have any operations like general information. You can see after this work order, general unreleased, everything will be there. Work definitions, items, such as details, completion informations. Right, once this product is complete, so it will be in the completion 7 entry. You can give here the completion 7 entry as my completed 7 entry, and the default subtype is my operations pole. Go back, go to the operations, create some operations. I go for a couple of operations instead of going for all the 4 or 5 operations. Go for first tear down. Right, click OK. I'll create another operation. After tear down, I'm going to assemble it. S21 assembly operations. Right. So these are the two operations I'm going to. I'm not going for testing some packing, all this. This is all again the same what we did, what you saw yesterday. So once you've done this, adding these operations right now, this along with this standard operations, this resource will come as whatever we define under this manager work definitions name. Like whenever you add these operations, the operation along with the operation, the resource will come in the picture. That's how we have defined in the S21 engine tear down, S21 assembly, and there we have defined, we attach these resources to this operations. So it came in. If you want to add another resource, or if you want to remove these resources, yes, you can go with this edit operation resources. First, let me add these items. So this is my ultra engine. I'm going to add, I'm putting my the old engine, the lower version engine, which need to be teared down. So which need to be put in this system. I want to upgrade it. DISEL. So have this part number. So I'm just adding one quantity. I'm issuing one quantity for one ultra engine. I'm giving the older version one engine as an operation full. I'm using it because this is the supply type which I have selected in the general information. That will be defaulted here by default. Otherwise, it will come from this item level, whatever the default supply type. Okay. And along with that, I'm going to issue another part number, which will to upgrade the teardown after teardown. I'm pulling one part number out from this teardown, like CM4751101, I think. Excuse me. So this part I want to remove from this old engine. I want to put in another part number, new part number, right? One part number, I'm removing it. This is the operation pull, and then click OK. So after teardown, I just want to add the additional part numbers. Whatever the upgraded version, whatever the new parts are coming in the upgraded version, those I'm going to add into this one. So click operations and click here plus. Go back here. CM4751103. Last time I added 01, I removed the part number from the old version. I'm just giving this upgraded part here, right? 03. I'm adding some three part numbers. Now operation pull. Click OK. And I will not, when I'm adding the part, normally it will not, I'll not use for 8 hours resource. I'll just use for 3 hours of the resources. Go here and edit operation resources. So instead of 8 hours, I'm using only for 3 hours resource time here. I just click OK. If you want to add another resource, you can add it. So it will be 3 hours. So I'm adding this lower version part number engine, and then another part which I want to remove from that lower version part. And then adding another part, three part numbers for the upper version, and this is my resources. So this is the way that we are going to create. This is how you need to create the transform order. The slight difference is if you create a rework or repair the same process, only difference is in the transform. When you are defining, it will clearly tell you which product you are going to transform in the first time when you are defining this transform work order. That's only the difference between the transform work order, rework and repair work orders. Save and close. T005. So this is unreleased. I'm going to release this work order. Just click the release. Once you release this work order, it got released. Now I'm going to execute this work order. Go to review dispatch list. And this is my assembly area. You can go for assembly area. If you know the work order number, yes, you can go. As a production schedule, I don't know the work order number. There are many people are creating work order, or sometimes the work orders are coming from my repair module, the service modules. So I don't want to go for create, don't want to search this work order numbers. I know my production area, my the assembly area, what are the work orders are in the pending, right? So I just click the search button. There's a one order in pending, right? Click here, and you can see. So there is nothing, there's no manual reporting, there's no push components are required for this operation, and there's no manually charged resource are exist for these operations. And click complete with the details. You can go one step back with complete also, go with the complete with the details. Next, and see this component I'm removing from this engine, and this engine I'm issuing for this ultra to manufacture. Next, and this is the 5 hours I'm using it. Save and close. Operation 10 got completed. Now the 20. Now 20 completed the details. Next, and these are the three components I'm issuing. For the upgrade product. Next. And 3 hours I'm using it. Next, I'm putting in this completed 700. Same close. So my work order got completed, done. I'm going to search my work order process here in this manage work orders. Make sure that you are selecting all options, search. Right, this is all my old one which I tested here. This is the T005 is my work order which got completed normal. So just click it. Go to history. And you can see here the transaction history. In transaction history, you can see here first the diesel engine, the lower version, I have issued that material. And I have removed this part number from this one. And there is also charge and operation completed. Operation complete. And the material is another material. I have three quantities. The product completion is one. This ultra engine got completed one. Right. So let me show you in this on and stock. Go to items, inventory. And once you go in the inventory, go to advanced search. Just let me see this engines. It should be 499. Previously, when we saw initially, it was 500. Now it's a 499, the total quantity. Let me show you the ultra engines. So underscore ultra. Just click ultra. 21 diesel. S21 diesel engine, you just click this diesel engine, this come, just select this diesel engine ultra, right? So once you click that, as initially we saw that there is no stock for this part number. Now we're going to see this part number, how much stock is exist. I see the one quantity, right? This is how you can able to track it and you can pull this stock. And again, go back to the inventories. There is something called like a review completed transactions. See the review completed transactions. If you want to see this item number S21, diesel engine ultra. This is my part number. This is nothing but a material transaction in EBS terminology. Select this part number. This is my latest one. And which date to which date? You can select that, or if you know the source type, transaction, everything is same as the material transaction form in EBS, and the search options also the same as in EBS. Click search. And you can see the work order numbers. So this is my work order. I did this all my previous transactions which I used. And this is the work order number. You can see the one quantity came here. Got it right. So this, if you click this transaction number, you'll get all this completed transaction and how this product came into the picture, like a work in process product completion, work order number, and work completion. This is my source reference, is nothing but the work order number, right? So all details will show in these transactions. This is same as the material transaction, different five or six tabs are there, right? The same way you are seeing here in this completion transaction in inventory side. So this completes the transform work order process and is pretty simple and straightforward. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me, supportj1978@gmail.com, or you can ask me directly, can ping me in this my LinkedIn too. Or if you need any trainings in cloud side or EBS, please connect with Nana and he will train you as an expert. Thank you. Bye-bye.